For this problem, you're going to develop a semi-implicit solver to model just a single corner of a car and its motion. You saw a diagram that looked pretty much just like this in the unit. Now, all of these arrows represent different types of quantities, but they're just useful for showing direction. V here represents the velocity of the car. W is the tangential velocity of the wheel. MQC is the mass of 1/4 of the car, and therefore MQC times G is equal to the gravitational force on this quarter of the car. F here represents friction, or the force of friction that is acting in this direction against the motion of the car. The force of friction is a function of S, which stands for wheel slip. We can write out the equation for the force of friction just like this. The force of friction is equal to, as you've seen before, the coefficient of kinetic friction, which is a function of wheel slip, times the normal force, which in this case has a magnitude equal to that of the gravitational force. We can relate some other important quantities to the force of friction. From right here, we can see that V dot, or the acceleration of the car, is impacted negatively by the force of friction. Change in the velocity of the wheel depends both on the force of friction and on B, which is the braking acceleration. S here, as you'll remember, stands for wheel slip, as I just said. We also, however, have this expression for mu, the coefficient of kinetic friction. Your first task in this problem is going to be to find an equation for W at the nth plus one time step that fits this form right here. In this equation, C, D, F, and K all could depend on a number of different things. For example, they might depend on W sub N, on H, the time step, on the mass of the quarter of the car, on the effective mass of the wheel, MEW right here, on G, the acceleration due to gravity, on B, the braking acceleration, or on V, the velocity. For V, which you see right here, we're going to use V sub N because, as it turns out, V changes very slowly compared to W. In fact, what we have is a stiff system of differential equations. You remember from our work earlier on in the course that stiff systems of differential equations require you to use a very small step size, or else they'll end up with completely unreasonable results. If you want to test this out, try plugging in h equals 0.1 seconds for the step size and see what kind of craziness ensues. In order to figure out what to plug in for C, D, F, and K here, we want you to use the backward Euler method along with the information that we've given you here. Looking at the code, you can see that we've given you a substantial portion of the program already. In fact, we've handed you this solver right here. Since we're asking you to use the backward Euler method, which is an implicit method, you're going to end up with an equation that is not linear, and therefore you can't solve explicitly. Once you've used the backward Euler method to come up with values for C, D, F, and K, we want you to use this solver in conjunction with the backward Euler method to come up with an expression for W at step plus one. In the solution video, I'll give you a more in-depth explanation of what this solver is doing and how it works.